On January 9th, 2020, I finally got the positive pregnancy test that we had been wishing for over a year. Due to some various issues, I had some very early ultrasounds. I finally had my first official OB appointment, and my doctor was unable to find the baby's heartbeat on the Doppler. She wasn't super concerned, but just to be safe, she sent me for another ultrasound. February 26th is a day I will probably never forget. My mom went with me to my ultrasound. There was a heartbeat, so I figured everything was fine. Then the technician came in with the phone saying it was my doctor. My OB said something was wrong and that some abnormalities were found. The baby's belly was larger than it should have been at that stage of my pregnancy. I was sent to maternal fetal medicine the next day, and after a few appointments, genetic testing, and many tears later, we were given the official diagnosis of an infallocele around 13 weeks. We had come to terms with the infallocele diagnosis, and we started planning for all of the possibilities it brought with our little girl. Around 20 weeks, I went in for a routine check at maternal fetal medicine. I had been going every so many weeks at this point, and with COVID restrictions in place, I had been going alone to appointments. At this appointment, the doctor thought she saw a heart defect called double outlet right ventricle, which prompted us to get to CHOP in Philadelphia for a consultation as soon as possible. A few days later, we had our first CHOP appointment. It was determined that baby girl did not have a heart defect, but I would deliver her at the special delivery unit at CHOP to care for her infallocele. Later on, the CHOP team decided I would deliver baby girl via C-section at 39 weeks. I had to relocate to Philly at 36 weeks to be closer in case she came early. On September 10th at 5:30 a.m., my water broke and Aubrey Ruth Parker decided to make her arrival at 38 weeks. Our girl was small at 5 pounds, 11 ounces, but strong and mighty. The first few days in the NICU were spent trying to figure out why Aubrey was having some feeding issues and her blood work just seemed off. We thought maybe she had an infection, but nothing was found. Finally, Dr. Adzik decided to do her repair on day 8 of life. During surgery, he found Meckel's diverticulum. Meckel's is a tiny bulge in the small intestine, which could have been the cause to her feeding problems early on.
Are you just flirting with all the male doctors?
Dr. Adzik repaired the Meckel's as well while doing her closure surgery. The next few days were spent working up to full feedings by bottle and pooping. I never thought I'd be so excited for my baby to poop, but there we were celebrating with her nurses every time. After that, the team began testing her sugars again and decided they were on the lower side. They kept her on a glucose IV to ensure she didn't go too low. Endocrinology was called in to do a consultation, and after an 18-hour fasting study, they diagnosed Aubrey with hyperinsulinism. The doctors put her on diazoxide and hydrochlorothiazide, and then a few days later, she had to do a 12-hour safety fast to be sure her sugars stayed high enough without food but with the medicine before we could go home. She passed, and we finally were able to be discharged to go home to Lancaster. On October 5th, Aubrey came home and finally got to meet our family. It was one of the best days ever. Thanks to COVID, my husband and I were the only ones who could be in the hospital, so the rest of Aubrey's family had to stick to the Angel Eye camera, FaceTime, and many, many pictures before we came home. We were adjusting to our new life at home, regular blood sugar checks, and medication at just the right time for fear of a low blood sugar. Then about a month after being home, we had another scare. Aubrey stopped breathing while I was driving, and I had to do CPR on the side of the highway. She was taken by ambulance to our local hospital, and then they transferred us back to CHOP. Every specialist under the sun saw Aubrey at that hospital stay there. All of her tests were normal, so they called it a BRUI, brief resolved unexplained event, and sent us home. The day after we came home, I went to get her medicine at the pharmacy, and she had another episode. This time, my brother had to do CPR on her, and we were again taken to the ER at our local hospital. This time, the doctor discharged us from the ER since she was stable and there was nothing else they could do. Being the Google searcher that I am, I found an FDA warning about the diazoxide, her medicine for the hyperinsulinism. The warning was literally what Aubrey was experiencing. Thankfully, she had been showing signs about growing her hyperinsulinism, so the endocrinologist was willing to stop her medicine. Even though we couldn't be 100% sure, that's what caused her breathing issues. She had to do another hospital stay for a 24-hour fasting cure study. She passed and was considered officially cured of hyperinsulinism on Thanksgiving Day. Since then, Aubrey has been thriving. She's growing and has been episode-free with her breathing problems. She was just discharged from her surgeon officially this month as well. If I could go back to last spring and tell myself one thing, it would be to trust and know that my daughter has the strength to overcome any obstacle in her way. She's a miracle. Though our story took a different path than I ever expected when I found out I was pregnant last January, we were stronger together, and our amazing warrior is here with us to show us what life is truly about. Moms-to-be of these precious angels, stay strong. Believe you can do this because you can and you will. It's going to be hard, especially in the middle of this global pandemic, and there will be days where you wish you could just be like that other mom-to-be you see on Facebook with no worries about the future of her child's health, but you will get through it, especially with the support of the moms in the Moose group. Oh, babies are amazing fighters who like to show everyone what they are made of. Aubrey is the strong, almost four-month-old that she is today because of the love and support we received from our family and friends. She's the angel we needed in our lives and the greatest blessing to our family. While our journey was fairly easy compared to some families in the Moose group, I hope that her story helps bring some hope and light to those feeling like they're in darkness and unsure of their baby's future.
Hehehehe